give this to Al Green. King. And my friend Muriel Davis Wilkins, who really is the centerpiece of this song, spiritually and otherwise. Stop me if you've heard this before. Muriel was a 65-year-old school teacher when I met her. You know, you take over, Glenn. Take over with a little background music there. All right. Muriel was 65 when I met her. I walked into this place called the Hollywood Cafe, and this is fresh off of hearing Reverend Al Green preach the gospel in his own church called the Full Gospel Tabernacle Church. So it was a religious week. And I'm a Jewish kid from Cleveland, so there was a large part of my trip to Memphis where I was wondering if my people didn't have the whole thing completely fucking wrong. Because I used to cry my eyes out in temple, but it wasn't because I was moved. It was just because I wanted to get the hell out of there. But in Reverend Green's church, something else was going on. People coming up and down the aisles, the music got more and more intense. Reverend Al Green's voice got more and more intense. Anyway, I left with that spirit when I met Muriel, who was also a great lover of gospel music. And to make a very long story short, I was still very young and was years away from getting signed, but I wanted to be a songwriter in the worst way. My only problem was I didn't have any good songs. And I knew that I still had a long way to go, and I told this to Muriel. And at the end of the night in this little place called the Hollywood Cafe, she invited me up on stage. Now, she'd been singing for 3 hours already. And at 65, that's no small feat. And when I got on stage, it was only then that we realized there wasn't one song both of us knew. So now what? So she just started singing what she normally ended the night with. And I tried to follow while she whispered lyrics into my ear. And there I was singing, "His eye is on the sparrow, near my God to thee, touch the hem of his garment," all the big Hebrew synagogue hits. And then she sang Amazing Grace, and I joined her a cappella. And the people that were making the catfish and fried pickles in this place, they came out from the kitchen and they sang along. Everybody was singing. And at the end, Muriel just whispered in my ear, "Child, I think you can go home and write those songs you've been meaning to write now." And that's exactly what happened. I got anointed by Muriel Davis Wilkins. And I went back home. And songs, I just couldn't stop the songs from coming. I haven't had that since. It was unbelievable. And I guess within a few months I had 8 or 9 new songs, but it wasn't the number, it was the fact that they all felt authentic and like I had begun to find some kind of voice. And I went back so excitedly to go play my new tunes for Muriel, so I went back to the Hollywood Cafe about 8 or 9 months later. And she listened so patiently to my new tunes. And when they were all done, she just said, smiling from ear to ear, "Child, I love those new songs." Because she knew she was a big part of them. And in fact said, "You know that one where you mentioned me at the end?" I said, "Of course." She said, "I think that's the best one." Walking with my feet 10 feet. feet off a beam, walking in Memphis. Rain.